क्योंकि आज आप जानते हैं कि देयर वाज अ नेशनल कन्वेंशन, सेवंथ नेशनल कन्वेंशन ऑफ द एनसीपी व्हिच वाज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड इन माउंटेन क्रॉस. Yesterday there was an extended working committee, and that working committee we have finalized the draft resolution which was ultimately discussed in today's convention. There were a lot of amendments, and the amended resolution was approved unanimously by our committee. We have taken and given topmost priority, everyone. My voice cannot go beyond this.
These are different mics.
You see, we have adopted one resolution mainly on situation of Kerala. The resolution says that the calamity of the Kerala because of the recent flood is such the government of India should take and announce it is a national disaster. The total information which we got from our colleagues from Kerala, and that was discussed in detail in our meeting, the total damage as per information which we have collected from government, unfortunately, NCP got one representative in the state government. Mr. Sachinder, he is very much here. And the total damage as per government report, 19,964 crore 68 lakhs. So somewhat near to 20,000 crore. Sector wise, agriculture, which is affected about 3,15,000 farmers, the total damage of the agriculture sector is 1,355. Animal husbandry, mostly poultry, goat and cow. The total damage in animal husbandry sector is 51 crore. Public works department, roads and bridges and buildings, 5,000 crore. Electricity power generation department, 3,500 crore. Road transport, 70 crore. Air traffic damage, including Cochin Airport, is about 200 crore. Rail sector 100 crore, telecommunication 88 crore, housing 8,000 crore, small scale industry 6,000 crore, and education institution about 1,000 crore. This is approximately 20,000 crore. These figures we have collected from Government of Kerala. We have adopted one resolution, mainly first resolution, regarding this unprecedented flood caused by the exceptional rain and ultimately affected in the rivers and public at large. I have explained and collected figures from Government of Kerala, which I have already explained. We have demanded four things. One, to grant sufficient financial assistance to Government of Kerala. Two, this is of course to address to Government of India, to allot necessary funds to the state at free of cost. Free. The objection is any accepting donation offered by foreign countries and United Nations should be waived and sanction may be given to the Kerala government to accept these contributions from all those who offer to help them. Fourth, the parameters defined for the calculating compensation for the loss of such distance have to be revised and sufficient amount may be made available for the people to get over the crisis. These are the four demands which we have made. Now question comes firstly about whether we should accept any foreign support, assistance. So I was told, and we have also seen in the media, Government of India has not accepted it, they have not approved. Generally, we do accept this approval. But the situation in Kerala is somewhat near to the exception situation. We have rejected previously, when Dr. Manmohan Singh was the Prime Minister, but here we feel there is a different case. Essentially, the monetary support has been offered to, particularly in Kerala, from Gulf countries. And we feel the Gulf countries' economy has been built up by many Indians, Bangladeshis and others. And the contribution of our colleagues from Kerala in the overall development of the Gulf countries and building economy of the Gulf countries is exceptional. And that's why those people who are, in fact, if we go to Dubai, the size of a population, I haven't got any figure, but might be 70-80% population. If we go to any establishment, any institution, any work which has been going, you will find Indians and particularly Keralais are contributing big way. So the people from that particular state have really contributed a lot for the overall development of that particular way. So I don't think we should object any financial support which they are offering, and we should not take this approach. Secondly, I recollect when, I don't exactly remember, but there was some problem in United States of America about 5-6 years back. And Government of India had contributed some amount, which American government has accepted. If the American government is accepting any small support which the Indian government is giving, I think now present government should not take this approach, and we should accept and try to resolve whatever the problem our colleagues from Kerala are facing. So our fourth demand, as I said, to grant sufficient financial assistance to the government of Kerala. I have seen in media, Government of India has announced initially 100 crores, and after visit of Honorable Prime Minister, he added another 500 crores. The total contribution which is coming to the Kerala from Government of India is 600 crores. And as I said, the total damage is somewhat near to 20,000 crores. So in that situation, I think it is a responsibility of Government of India to support Kerala big way and try to resolve the many problems of people whom Kerala is facing. Number two, our demand to allot necessary fluidians to the state at free of cost. This is not the first time happening. I recollect I was looking after the food ministry for 8-10 years. On many occasions, when there was a calamity, we have offered food grants at free of charge to some of the states. Number three, the objection of India accepting donations, which I have already said. And then fourthly, parameters defined for the calculating compensation for such disasters have to be revised. The parameters which are finalized, I think that is about 6 or 7 years back. In 7 years, all of costing everything has been substantially changed. That parameters when were finalized, these parameters were essentially for normal flood, for drought, and some other calamities. I happened to be the chairman of that committee in those days, and that's why I'm fully aware about what exactly situation which we are facing. But today's Kerala's situation is altogether different. Scale and size of the Kerala disaster is much higher size, and that's why the parameters which were finalized about 7 or 8 years back, I don't think that is sufficient, and it will not give justice to the people from Kerala. That's why that should be changed. In fact, when UPA government was there, one particular issue was discussed in those days, and I was also associated. That is the particular area which has been affected more is Kutnar. In Kutnar, Dr. Swaminathan was requested to prepare the detailed proposal. Dr. Swaminathan has submitted proposal. I myself visited as a Minister of Agriculture in that area, discussed with local leaders, government, chief minister, everybody. And then, after returning to Delhi, we have approved a special package for that particular area. Money was offered. Money was offered, money was allotted. But unfortunately, then government has not implemented Kutnar seriously. And that's why what situation has been worsened, particularly in that Kutnar belt, the reason is that package was not implemented seriously. In fact, I saw the statement of Dr. Swaminathan. He said, if I could not for a package, if it would have been properly implemented, this calamity would not be there. Anyhow, now happen is happened, but still, I think it is our responsibility to forget about what happened in the past and support the people of affected people of Kerala. Of course, in today's meeting, we have passed a condolence resolution also because about 365 people died in Kerala in this episode. There were some cattle also, and our convention has taken a special note of the efforts and initiative which has been taken by Honorable Chief Minister of Kerala to handle this entire situation. The Honorable Chief Minister is practically day and night spending his time. He is trying to associate each and every cross section. Irrespective of political differences, he is trying to associate everybody. An entire government machinery he has made disposal to resolve all these issues. This is the exceptional good work Kerala government is doing. I would like to congratulate Honorable Chief Minister and his team, and we have passed a special resolution appreciating Honorable Chief Minister's efforts. Of course, our resolution also, we have taken note of Kerala's situation, but along with Kerala, similar situation was some part of Karnataka, Assam, North and other national northeastern states, we have been equally suffering caused by devastating floods. So whatever demand which we have made for Kerala, Government of India should also look in this state and try to support them. And now today's meeting, we have passed one resolution. That resolution on social, economic and political situation of the country. I think we are distributing some copies to all of you. That's why it's a lengthy thing, I will not read and take your time. Secondly, it will be distributed. Secondly, my speech, this copy also will circulate and we have circulated. That has taken many steps. Now, if you want anything about this, certainly you are welcome.
Sir, you have spelled out by the opposition strategy in Mumbai that statewide alliance is being made. So, what is the response from all over the country?
Firstly, that my thinking, which I had explained in one of the first meetings in Bombay, but it was my responsibility to take my party's approach first. In today's meeting, we had discussed this and we had taken approval unanimously by party. So I'll be able to start now negotiation, discuss with other party leaders. Informally, I have discussed with many, but officially, I have not discussed yet. Now I will start that process. We won't. I honestly feel it is better to resolve the issues on state-wise among the non-BJP parties and provide some viable alternative in this state to replace BJP from that particular state and ultimately at national level. For instance, states like Maharashtra, my own home state, we have discussed with Congress. We have discussed with Peasants and Workers Party. And Congress and Peasants and Workers Party and NCP has come together and we have decided to go and face election collectively. Of course, the detailed discussion regarding distribution of seats and others will be completed in next 2 to 3 months and then we'll start working together. So I'm just giving example of us on similar way. We would like to create same situation in other parts of our country.
Sir, the opposition is supporting the urban nationalize. What is the stand of NCP on that and the various arrests that
sir, I don't understand. Opposition is supporting that statement.
The opposition parties, political parties are supporting the urban nationalize.
No, firstly,
what is the NCP stand
firstly,
on that and your stand on the Maharashtra arrest?
Firstly, after getting information about the Maharashtra arrest, I have decided tomorrow or day after tomorrow I will go to these people, practically everybody's house, and discuss with local population, their neighbors and everybody. I don't want to give details, but I know some of them personally.
So who are they or whom you know personally?
Why don't you listen? So I know them personally, some of them. I will not disclose all these details now. After meeting the families and neighboring people, definitely I will address a face with them. But I know some of them, and they are activists. They are leftists. Their ideology is left, but I never heard that they are associated with Nazism. those who are whose thinking is a sort of left thinking or even Maoist thinking, I cannot call them, as each and every person is a Naxalite. So those who have been arrested, at least in my home state, I know some of them, they are activists. But it is very unfortunate thing, the government and the police authority are arresting them in the name of their association with Naxalite movement.
But sir, the police are saying that there are concrete evidence against them.
That ultimately we'll see in the court of law. Fortunately, judicial system in this country is not controlled by present government or anybody.
But sir, that means we are trying to ask the government to allow me to without knowing that.
Enough. My information about documents, nothing is there. Not really serious papers are there. Some notes here and there are there. After my visit to the family, I'll be able to brief you on this. But I know some individuals, and these some individuals, as for my information, they are not the people who will go to extreme level to assassination of X or Y.
Do you think that this is to counter this Sanatan activities in Maharashtra?
You see, there is a general impression in Maharashtra, in learned section, the last few days, continuously, the police authority, particularly from Karnataka, has gone in depth about this assassination of Kabirji, assassination of Dabulkar, assassination of Pansare, Congress Pansare, assassination of Gauri Lankesh, and all these assassinations, they have arrested some people. They got some information. And that information, what I read in the newspaper, I haven't got any authentic information. But what I read in the newspaper, according to that, there are certain organizations that are closely associated with these assassinations. If that information is factually correct, I think there anybody can definitely come to conclusion just to divert attention from that particular incidences and those who are involved in incidences, unnecessary importance are given to these people who are activists, might be four or five people, might be arrested from Maharashtra or other parts.
Sir, that is what the question is.
I have given a lot of time to you.
Sir, the question was. Pune police ne jo bhi karwai ki
आज मैं पूरी गलत ऐसे नहीं कहूँगा, मगर जिनको अरेस्ट किया इनमें से कुछ लोगों को मैं जानता हूँ, वो एक्सट्रीमिस्ट या माओ या डिस्ट्रक्टिव अप्रोच, इस तरह की उनकी बैकग्राउंड नहीं
है.
Informally, I got one or two, three meetings with Congress President. Now I will continue that. Then, because mainly Congress is a major party, particularly in my home state and others, and after discussing with, then we will also take their consent to discuss with others.
Sir, I just like to see the same point which he was asking. Now that you are looking at it in the larger picture, one is of course in Maharashtra and the earlier form there was 26-22. You are trying to get other parties also on board this time to become a more omnibus to have the representation of more parties in Maharashtra. And you have also in Bihar. In that context, don't you feel, because the BJP keeps saying you don't have a prime ministerial candidate. You were the first one to say under Manmohan Singh should be projected as the prime ministerial candidate in 2009.
Not now. I don't think that issue is a serious issue. I myself had briefed At least I recollect on two occasions the situation was such similar. In 1976, I recollect, when there was no Janata Party. After emergency, when Mrs. Gandhi announced election, elections were announced, there was no party. Jayaprakash made one statement. On the basis of that statement, some people came together, fought election, defeated Mrs. Gandhi and Congress Party. And after the election, Janata Party was formed. And after the election, after formation of Janata Party, leader was elected Morarji Bhai Desai. Morarji Bhai Desai was not projected as a Prime Minister candidate at that time. Similarly, in 2004, where I was a party in that discussion, after that election, I recollect Dr. Manmohan Singh and Pranab Mukherjee came to my house and we discussed together, and we decided to form an alternative government with a request to other like-minded political parties. We never contested election on one party. We never projected anybody as a leader. We just sat together, discussed with various political leaders, prepared minimum common program that was approved, and Dr. Manmohan Singh was elected as the leader of that formation, UPA. And 10 years we have provided a stable government to the country. So that whether projecting A or B is not really important issue at this stage.
And 26-22 formula?
No formula that we have not discussed. Whether how many seats, we are just discussed, we would like to go together.
Sir, given your seniority and stature, will you really play the alliance maker of bringing parties together? I mean, while you have been talking about coming together, if you look at these three states, Andhra Pradesh, Congress and BSP are having problem in coming to a seat sharing, even in Chhattisgarh, Rajasthan. So will you, take the lead in being the
I am not taking lead, but I am discussing with my own friends in different political parties. Firstly, I should not say about seniority, but I can definitely say the person who is taking interest or initiative, he should not be the candidate. So I have no personal interest. So the gentleman who hasn't got any personal interest, I think it is easy for him to discuss with others who got some
interest. Opposition party में कुछ पार्टियाँ ऐसी हैं जिनको सीबीआई के थ्रू threaten किया जा रहा है कि यूनिटी ना हो, खासकर यूपी में. आपको इसके बारे में कुछ जानकारी
है? हमारे पास जानकारी नहीं, मगर हमारे मन में इस तरह की आशंका है कि कुछ जगह पर इस सभी प्रोसेस की मदद आज यह सरकार लेगी, चाहे किसी को मालूम नहीं, ये इन्वेस्टिगेशन एजेंसी की मदद लेगी और किसी को दूसरी एजेंसी की मदद ले, ये ले सकते हैं, ये कर सकते हैं, ऐसे कुछ बातें इससे पहले देखी थी, पर आज मेरे पास स्पेसिफिक इसमें कुछ इन्फॉर्मेशन नहीं.
सर, आपने कहा था अपने भाषण में कि 2004 की तरह जिस तरह से अलग अलग पार्टियों ने राज्यों के स्तर पर लड़ाई लड़ी थी, अगला लोकसभा का चुनाव उसी स्तर पर लड़ा जाए, लेकिन आपको क्या लगता है कि कांग्रेस आज 2004 की तरह मजबूत है और बीजेपी 2004 की तरह कमजोर?
नहीं, सवाल नहीं है. 2004 में भी जब गवर्नमेंट बनने की स्टार्ट थी तब प्रधानमंत्री अटल बिहारी वाजपेयी थे. 5 years prior to that was the rule under the leadership of Atal Bihari Vajpayee, which country has seen. And that time, Congress situation was not that strong. And that's why it was easy for all of us.
So there are some parties in the opposition, and you being the person who has been able to reach out, like for example, Aam Aadmi Party, or Naveen Patnaik's party, or Chandrasekhar's party, KCR's party, like that. How do you, because there cannot be state level alliances, because there are certain issues and misgivings already between the principal opposition party, the Congress, and those parties.
In fact, I have not discussed these gentlemen whose name you have referred. But next month or 15 days, I will start meeting the people. I think it's possible. There are some difficulties. It's not that simple. But it's possible to resolve these difficulties.
Sir, even if you're saying that UAE offer is an exceptional case, but But the government of India is saying that the stand taken by Manmohan Singh government is the main roadblock for accepting foreign fund. So is that the UPA's own policy is now making a block to accept the foreign fund?
Yes, in Kerala.
Yeah.
No, I say, yes, the previous government has said. But that situation and this situation were different. That situation, those, in fact, money which was coming was not for Kerala. And in Kerala, as I mentioned, the contribution of the colleagues from Kerala in Gulf is enormous, which everybody accept there. And that's why there is a case to accept. Situation is different as compared to other states.
So you have been watching Shivsena for quite a few decades. Do you see Shivsena aligning with the BJP for the 2019
election? I can't say anything because I am not discussed with them. I'm just reading Samna newspaper. That shows me something different. But I think that showing me to go, they are going in this direction. I have not seen what exactly their direction actually is, because they are going from this direction or that direction.
Any other states beyond Maharashtra and Bihar, the NCP is looking for contest in the 2019
year? No, of course we have discussed with others, no? In other states also.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you.